motherfuckers wanna get famous. Yo, 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 what is up, guys? It's One Out of Master, and on today, we are back and better after the break. We are back on Xenoverse 2, and as you guys can see, Kai has changed a little bit. He has ascended, not to the Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan level, but something a little, maybe more aggressive, but passive? I don't know. You guys decide, but the homie Kai is level 99. We did the grind. We grinded. It took like 45 million XP, but it's all cool. It's all good, boys. So we did that. But as by the title of the video, we're gonna play with every fusion character in the game in their key matchups in history. We're gonna do more videos like this as time goes on and Xenoverse 2 goes off into its life cycle and probably into DLC 5, since there is most likely going to be a DLC 5. DLC Pack 4 was pretty lit. Was here for all of that. Did all that stuff. It's been pretty dope. Super Saiyan 4, Ultimate Kai, all that stuff has all been pretty dope. But alright, boys, let's get into the fusion gameplays. Let's get it.
I'll show you what it's like.
Alright, boys, now if I'm correct, we got the first official fusion in all of Dragon Ball here. If I'm. It's either Gotenks or Vegito. One of like the first, out of the Saiyans anyways, because I know there's a few characters like Kami Nail and Piccolo, all those guys technically are fused characters, but I mean like out of the Saiyans, we got the famous fuses. We got the homie Gotenks here, and his first matchup was against Super Buu. Yeah, they were actually training to become fused because of Buu and everything that was going on, when the dads could not get to them in time with Goku being dead or not having enough time on Earth, easy. Piccolo had to train Goten and Trunks and Lakabal Tom to take the fusion dance. And what I honestly don't understand is how that in Super, the kids are still like super young and stuff like that. But I mean, it is supposed to be like directly after the Buu Saga, so it kind of does make sense. But being in the time chamber, you would think they'll be like GTA. I don't know. Because it's supposed to accelerate your age and stuff like that. But Trunks and Goten are still like 8 years old. I don't know. Ooh, Boo got the combos. Gotenks is actually pretty nice if you know how to use him. Honestly, I do not use his character enough. But he do got some nice combos. Oh, that's a second. Oh, and he also has the ability to go Super Saiyan 3. Yeah, man. SSJ3 Gotenks. Let's get into the next fusion. Alright, boys. Now we got my favorite character in all of Dragon Ball and in like every Dragon Ball video game that he exists in, Vegito. Vegito is the plethora fusion of Goku and Vegeta, the god fusion of Goku and Vegeta. Well, yeah, since he technically was with the god earrings. He's considered the god fusion out of the two that they do have. Because Gogeta was with the Mediterranean dance and stuff like that. I don't know how to fucking pronounce the word, but that's the dance and these are the earrings. And according to the manga, the fucking earrings are stronger. I don't want to hear comments. Go take it up with Dragon Ball. And this is Super Vegito. And I bet people were gonna say, why are you fighting Broly? Well, dudes, Buhan and Bootinks don't exist in this video game, which is very sad because all you have to do is make a variant. But anyways, we're not gonna talk about that. We're just gonna get back into the man with the plan, Vegito. But Broly, honestly, I've been using a lot of mustache, so I think. Take that, yeah, man. Ooh, scrumptious. Still alive, I see. Looks like I'll just have to make you perish. Ooh, that's a thumbnail. That was nice. All right, boys, let's get into the next fusion fighter. Alright, boys, out of all of the non-canon characters, this is probably the most OP non-canon character in all of existence. If you guys know who Gogeta is or have ever seen Fusion Reborn, you guys will know this man don't play no games. I mean, like, dude, the whole transformation scene before they, like, turned into Gogeta was just astronomical. Like, dude, the man was so fucking strong. He had stars moving in the galaxy. Like, that shit's ridiculous. Like, look at this shit. Janemba broke my stamina. What the fuck? Oh, okay. Honey, on why? That's so fun. Because if I would have did the combo like he did in the movie, it would have killed him. I'm just gonna lie. I'm just saying. It would have killed him. And those are facts. That combo right there. Alright, boys, that match is actually pretty damn fast. And that is Super Gogeta. Alright, boys, we got the other non-canon fusion, as in Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. And this man has a shitload of health. In all honesty, who do you guys think was cockier between the two? Do you think Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta was cockier, or do you think Vegeta was cockier? Because in the animes, in Grand Tour and in Z, Vegito was so damn strong that he's honestly toyed with Boo the entire fight. I'm not even, like, if you guys haven't seen the original Dragon Ball Z, like, go watch it. Like, don't even watch all the filler episodes. Just watch, like, the main stuff. Because, I mean, dude, Gogeta, Vegito, yeah, dude. Honestly, two of the cockiest fusions. Goku and Vegeta are just some strong ass characters. Like, it's crazy, man. Like, look at this shit. That was supposed to be a comment. AKA the bluff coming out now. And Gogeta would have destroyed Omega Shenron according to, like, the statements in the canon and stuff, but they were so damn strong that their fusion had a time limit on it as well. So instead of being fused for about 30 minutes, they were fused for about 10 minutes, just like Super Saiyan Blue Vegito in the new age Dragon Ball Super. Yeah, the Potara, honest, apparently isn't unlimited anymore, because it used to be like you can't defuse once you put the earrings on, but now there's rules and crap according to Dragon Ball Super, which is pretty dumb. Ooh, Omega Shenron got the combos. I know this is super good one, because, dude, I'm going to get all the rest of the original characters, like, hit and all the ice dragons, so I just don't feel like doing this stuff right now. Oh, I got a build video coming out with you guys soon, too. With the level 99 version of Kai. Well, that worked out perfectly. Alright, boys, let's get into the next Saiyan fusion. Alright, boys, we are here with the DLC pack for Vegito Blue and Merged Zamasu. Ooh, ooh. Vegito is honestly, dude, like, if you play rank, like, with him, it's like, dude, his character is honestly so damn strong, it's ridiculous. Like, the fucking dump trucks. Dump trucks. Honestly, the most overpowered character in Dragon Ball's universe. Alright, boys, we're gonna keep it sweet and end it with a 2v2. Looks like Vegeta has Zamasu, so I will take on Goku Black. And guys, what do you guys think about how Dragon Ball Super is going on? How Dragon Ball Super is going on, you know, with the whole Universal Tournament arc? Because, like, dude, if I'm correct about some of the stuff I've been talking about, oh my god, that shit ain't gonna be sweet. Oh, Black, you should have did it. That was my body to begin with. Let me hit that Kaioken. Oh, yes. It wasn't even needed. Boys, what do you guys think about Goku, like, with the whole Super Saiyan Blue, like, spam? Because, in all honesty, he uses his transformation way too damn much. My boy Vegeta putting in work on the whole Zamasu. The Super Saiyan's about to put in work? I don't think so! Alright, boys, well, I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. More ranked matches will come soon. And until we meet again, guys, I will see you guys later. Peace out, everybody.
Been a long time, and this here's been a long rhyme, so I gotta go. It's logic, the one nobody would vouch for. How's that shit for an outro?